Welcome to this Calendly tutorial. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to create collective events. But before we do that, I would like to add some background information. I'm going to use an example with two users, Charles and Greg. Let's assume Charles is from the sales department and Greg is from the IT department. Let's also assume that they work for a company which installs information technology equipment that is complex. So for a customer to get a quote, Charles and Greg have to be present in that meeting. Therefore, the company uses collective events. What they do is that they check that Charles and Greg are available at what times, and the invitee can schedule the meeting at those times. So that is how collective events work. Now, I'm going to create a collective event. So on your home page, under Charles, we're going to create a new type of event by clicking the new event type button. And we go to the collective events and click create. So we have to add the secondary user, who is Greg. There we go, and we click next. Now we have to name the event, but I want you to notice something different. It actually shows that there is Charles and there is Greg in this collective event. So let's say it's a quote, 15 minutes. 15-minute, let's name it that way. Then we can actually put instructions there that the customer might want to know. We can say, please leave your details in the form that will come on the registration page. We can now choose a color that we like. Let's just choose green so that we can differentiate the events. What we do next is to click the next button. Now it takes us to the next section where it says, when can people book this event? So we say it is a 15-minute event. Under date range, we need to choose how far into the future people can actually book this event. So let's say 30 days so that people don't forget. Now, remember the options. You can choose for the days to be rolling. They will continuously roll into the next month, the 30 days. We can also choose a date range to say from this point in time to that point in time is when people can book. And we can actually put an indefinite period where people can book anytime into the future. Right now, we're going to use over a period of rolling dates, which are 30 days into the future, starting from the current date. So we hit apply. The next section is the event time zone. So for us to make a customization, we have to click edit. So there are two types of time zone styles. There's a local time zone style and a locked time zone style. So if we use a local time zone style, what this means is that the invitees will see your availability in that time zone. So we usually use this for virtual meetings. However, there's this second type of time zone style where you have to lock to a specific time zone. Usually this is more recommended in an in-person meeting. So you can actually choose from a list of time zones depending on which part of the world you live in. So for now, we're going to use the local time zone. Under availability, this is where you set the available hours when people can schedule meetings with you. So that I show you how to schedule these times. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to press Monday. Click on Monday. So we're going to say the availability of these two members. They are available from 8 o'clock to, let's say, 11 o'clock, 1100 hours in the morning. This is when people can book with these two members on Monday. You can actually add a new interval if there is a break in between the times. You can also use the unavailable times to block out areas where people cannot book for these two members at the same time. So after this, we press apply to all Mondays. So what you notice is that for these two people, in a collective event, people can only book from 8 to 11 a.m. on Mondays. We can actually do that for the rest of the days. Remember, don't forget to go to the advanced section. It gives you more options. We can have the frequency of available time slots for the invitees shown in slots of 30 minutes, 1 hour, 10 minutes, depending on what you want. Right now, let's just show it in increments of 15 minutes because our slots are also 15-minute slots. You can actually do more. It depends on how you want the booking page to look like. Let's say we want a maximum number of events. Let's say 3 maximum number of events per day. So you can actually limit the number of events per day by using this section. Minimum scheduling notice is very important. You use the setting to prevent last minute events where people just book within a short space of time and you don't have time to prepare for the meeting. So probably let's just say 6 hours for Charles. Now you can also use event buffers. These help you to have enough time to go into the next meeting. Enough time to prepare yourself to go into the next meeting, because it might have been that within a specific time slot, just after you finish a particular meeting, you're going to the next meeting. So in this instance, it gives Greg and Charles time to go for the next meeting. So let's just say after the meeting, after each meeting, they get 10 minutes before the next event starts. So Calendly will make sure that there is a buffer in the meetings of 10 minutes. Then you click next. Now you need to choose the locations where the host will be. So we can actually choose an in-person meeting, a phone call, a Zoom, web conference. Let's just say it's an in-person meeting for now. Where are they located? Let's say 27 Churchill Avenue. And we press update. So 27 Churchill Avenue will actually be shown on the booking page. And that's where these two people, Charles and Greg, will be available. After doing this, click next. So in this video, we're only going to talk about this first section. The additional options are going to be discussed in the other videos that I've posted on the YouTube page.